You know what I want to drink right now?
What do you want to drink right now?
Something special.
Ooh. Oh, look at the bottle. The bottle looks special. Oh, but it's cold. That's very funny. You know what? Let's try something
Let's
special.
Let's try something special. This is from Eric Nix, the magnificent bastard.
Eric Nix, you magnificent bastard.
Now,
that's really good.
On one hand, I love the name, and the bottle shape reminds me of...
It looks like something special.
Remember the one that we had the other day? And I don't think it's been inventoried yet, but it was in the budget Scotch line from Peter Golden, but the bottle shape was really cool.
I don't
remember? It had like this like diamondy shaped...
Nope. Should I wander too?
No. I was gonna pull it up, but I don't know where it is. Yes, wander. There's only two places it could be. And I don't think we have, Antiquary. It did get inventoried.
We did it.
You see this?
Yeah.
See what I mean?
Oh yeah, that is very angular. Yeah,
right?
Different bottles, but.
Yeah, totally
same
different.
Idea.
But who releases this one? I don't remember. Anyway.
See, I love.
Weird bottles?
I love weird bottles. Even if it's, you know, even if the whiskey is whatever. The fact that it looks so different.
Right.
Because it's so easy to get into sameness. A lot of people, just for whatever reason, their instincts, whenever they're putting bottle and label designs together, it feels very, very familiar. What's going on here?
I don't know.
Let me poke it.
Oh, it's got a shot ball so that you pour an exact amount every time.
That's not a shot.
No, it's not.
Let me poke it with my finger.
Yeah, we really need to take that thing out.
Let me just little bobbity boop. Well, then I'll know if you're going to be able to use that if you take that off.
Oh, that's permanently in there.
Here, this is what you do. You shove your knife up the whiskey hole, and you hold that ball out of the position. That's not it at all. This is, sure, that's fine. This is all fine. Now we get plastic that fits in our whiskey.
It doesn't want to come out. It really is that little plastic ball they put in there to, like, change.
Ah, you gotta shake it.
Like
you
a just ketchup. It's like a ketchup bottle.
Right, do that again.
Yeah, shake it. Shake it like a Polaroid picture. Such bullshit.
There is such a thing as being too different, fellas.
Yeah. Okay, so here's the thing.
It's so special. It's very, very stingy about how much it gives you.
Yeah, I'm gonna rip that out, that plastic bullshit. So this is Chivas. This is actually supposed to be kind of like a nicer blend.
Okay.
And I'll tell you a little thing that they said. I don't know if it's still true.
Yeah.
But there's supposedly a lot of Longmorn in here.
Okay. There's a density to this nose.
Did you hear that said?
A lot of Longmorn.
Longmorn.
Do you need to sit down?
Remember how, well, I don't know. They might have just ruined it with everything else they put in it. But... remember we said Longmorn only releases a certain amount of things because so much of what Longmorn makes goes into blends.
Right.
Evidently, this is one of them.
Okay. So, dense,
thick
nose.
Still only 40, but it doesn't smell like
no,
it.
No, it does not. It's punching well above
40%. And it does not smell overly grain brittle. No, it smells more malt must.
It's like, it's probably one of the mustiest
blends
I've put my nose in.
This was...
There's a fruity character behind that.
This is considered luxury retail blend.
Okay.
Oh, I gotta say, I kind of like that. Ooh. For a budget blend, I don't know what the budget is.
The vanilla cream and the fruit shows up on the taste even more so.
Let's see what it goes for on the interwebs.
And this little thread of earthiness takes you home with the finish there. You can tell it's 40% on the taste, just in terms of the texture of the thing. But the flavors, for the full, like, three quarters of the way through, the flavors is like, wow,
they're up there.
That's a rich, you know, layering of flavors. And then the last quarter, you can tell it's a low proof.
This is somewhere in the 30s.
No kidding.
This is monkey shoulder pricing.
Wow. That's special.
How does it compare to monkey shoulder, you think? It's something special. Now the question is it special like that's special? Or something like, oh, he's special. That's so southern.
Huh. Bless his heart.
You're special.
Bless your heart.
Yeah.
Which in southern talk means die in a fire.
Yeah. Oh, bless your little heart.
My wife says that all the time.
Oh, bless his heart. Yeah. I keep going back to this. This might be a reasonable budget refill replacement on my and my dad's whiskey nights.
It's...
I want to put it up against Monkey's shoulder.
That's fine. There's a nice... There's a nice complexity to this.
Yeah.
There's a lot of layers. I get like this almost a candy sweetness, vanilla, then this creamy quality. The fruitiness is in there. And then there's it's very thin. I'm hesitant to even say like an earthy quality because I don't think it would even register for most people.
Oh, I should keep the bottle down.
And I'm acclimating to it very quickly. And this, what did you just pour? The
monkey? Monkey shoulder.
You know what? I think if you liked one, you're very likely to like the other.
Oh, yeah. The monkey shoulder has more mustiness to it.
Yeah.
But the something special is a little bit more like vanilla light.
And I would say the monkey shoulder has a little bit more of like...
Taste it. The monkey shoulder is better. It's got more character. It's more character than I remember compared to this.
Yeah. Honestly, though... I think we're nipping at the edges. I would put them on very close to even playing fields.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And for the price point, they're definitely competitive with each other.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Something special. Is this like, is it getting a wide release? Is it just a weird, funky?
It's been around for a very long time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's special enough at that price point. I would say at $30, it's pretty special.
Oh, you can get it on Drizzly for $22.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Yeah. Talking about budget blends, I'm thinking this is a nicer budget blend.
Yeah.
With a hell of a price point.
I agree.
Yeah. Now, if you spend double the money, you're going to get something noticeably nicer. Yeah.
So,
but at that level, at that price point.
Eric wrote all over this bottle, feeling backwards, Eric Nix becomes Cire Xin, the king of chill.
So I did that game with a girl in middle school, and we would call each other by our names backwards.
Oh yeah, that's adorable.
No, I don't remember her. I call her Nofstrock.
Nofstrock. So what'd that be?
I think
Courtney.
No, her last name. I was called
about. Oh.
Nofstrock. Would that be Consford? Consford. I think it was her last name. Consford.
Ah.
Nofstrock.
I used my name backwards for like a username in a bunch of old video
Maybe
games.
No, I can't. Consford? Not sure. I don't know. Somewhere.
Leonad.
Leonad?
L-E-I-N-A-D.
Sounds like you should be in the, what's it called? Ulysses in the Iliad?
Yeah, yeah.
The Iliad.
Leonad.
You should be an Iliad character. Yeah, yeah.
My name is Leonad. But then I added wallaby because I thought it was a funny word. Oh. Because wallaby, there's two words that I think are really funny no matter how you use them.
Yes.
Weasel.
Yeah.
It's always funny.
Yeah.
And wallaby, for some reason, is very funny,
so,
phonetically.
Yeah. Leonad Wallaby. Leonad Wallaby, he's the guy that is like, he's all ripped up, he's shredded, right? He's like got the cape, and he goes to boot a guy in the pit, and he misses, and he just falls in. Yeah.
Like, he's always prepped to look badass until the action calls for it, and then he always flubs. He always flubs.
Freaking Leonad, you okay?
Yeah.
Stupid wallaby.
This is Leonad Wallaby. F***ing wallaby.
We got Lorenz. The more I watch your channel, the more I realize that Rex has some favorites. Ardbeg, Octomore, Ball Blair, but mainly loves weird flavors in whiskey.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I definitely have, when I'm just like wanting to chill out and relax and have something that I know to be nice, I have, you know, several brands that I feel comfortable reaching for. But the things that are the most fun, I would say, at this point, are just the weird things. Yeah. And even if I'm not necessarily like, oh, I love this.
Yeah, but you like the adventure.
The novelty.
Yeah,
the weird, just off the beaten path stuff.
Yeah, they've got me pigeonholed here. We keep reading.
Oh, Alessia Morris, I think we've all figured out at this point that Rex's whiskey aesthetic is anything that will punch him in the mouth and take him on a new adventure. Daniel just likes things how he likes them.
Yeah. Pretty accurate.
So are you an old man stuck in your ways?
Dude, I've been an old man since I was 5. You know what? So I was riding bikes with the boys on trails in McKinney Falls, and Cash is on this BMX bike on mountain bike trails, and he's just handling it. He's just handling it. But we're going uphill for like the 8th time, and Jackson and I have gears, and Cash has a BMX, and he's like just working his ass off trying to get up these hills, and he's totally doing it. Right. And halfway through, he's like, oh, my lower back really hurts. Like 10. And I was like, oh, you all right there, buddy? He's like, yeah, in some ways, I'm just an old man. And I was like, yep.
What is he like? Was he like 9?
Yeah, he's 10.
He's 10.
This is what he's riding his bike. Oh, my lower back really hurts. In some ways, I'm just an old man.
Uh-huh. Yeah. As a Whittington, you already had no chance.
Yeah.
If you're claiming old manitude.
Yeah.
At 10. It's like, dude.
Yep.
So I would say between these, Monkey Shoulder is going to be a funkier
and more vibrant.
Yes, and but richer.
But this has a little bit of more of an like a barrel ashy, earthy tone,
and also a little bit more of a creamy quality.
Mm-hmm. Weird combo, but it is true.
Budget blends.
Yes.
Budget blends.
Yes.
All right. Here's Vine Stealing Drink.
If you fight me, a fight for a friend.
If you steal, may you steal your liver.
And if you drink, may you drink with us.